Hey y'all, Samufacturing here. I thought it would be cool to do a little video of me just making the SuperCAT and SuperCAT sound cables. I made a video a while back of them in stop motion, and a few people asked to just do them in normal speed, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make a video of making the SuperCAT cable, just terminating it, as well as the SuperCAT sound and terminating it. And yeah, I hope that people find them interesting or funny or just have good insights into how we do things here at SoundTools and my very fun job that I do while I'm unemployed from college. So yeah, hope y'all enjoy. I really do want to say though, my biggest piece of advice for making these cables, and I just cannot emphasize this enough, is that when you do so, do your best to be surrounded by dogs. It's very important to the making of the cable. It's very important to your own happiness. And it's just very important in general. So yeah, really just, I think that you really need to think about that. And yeah, all right, I hope you guys enjoy the videos. Today I'm gonna show you guys how I terminate and how we all at SoundTools terminate the SuperCAT cable. After the little like video I posted of just doing the like little, I guess, stop motion video of me terminating them, I had a few requests to do it in just like the normal speed version. So you ask and I shall provide. So today it'll be in this video, it'll be just this SuperCAT sound. This is obviously not the typical length that we sell. We have a lot of standard lengths and none of them are these. However, if you really want this little short guy, you can do a little custom length for little short guy. These cables come in both black and purple. And yeah, we will just be terminating this guy. So the first part that we do is we put on this little shrink wrap friend. As you can see, we have shrink wrap on both ends. This is basically just so if you want to have a label, you can put it in there because there's no way you're gonna get shrink wrap on after it's terminated. It's just not happening. Or if you do, it will be extremely inefficient. So we have this little shrink wrap, and if you don't want it, you can just cut it off, but also you can just shrink it, and that's fun because shrink wrap's the best. And then, very important, you put the boot on. We are refilming this because I forgot to put on the boot, even though I've done this a bajillion times. You can't get the boot on after you finish it, so don't forget the boot. After you have the boot on, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna strip the cable. You wanna make sure that you have enough space to like actually mess around and terminate it properly, but also if you give yourself too much, it's gonna be kind of a bummer because you have to unbraid a bunch of mesh, and this is the mesh, and it's very annoying to unbraid. You put that little bit in the trash pile. So this is the little mesh shield guy, and I find that it's kind of helpful to just press down on it a little bit. It makes the unbraiding process a little easier. And then you basically just work from the top to the bottom to unbraid. And you try and do it impatiently, as I always do, and it makes things a lot worse. So you don't do that. We have patience in our existence and life. And we work things through methodically and not with a lot of aggression. The next part is that we get this little rubber bit. With this, I use this tool. It's just like a little sharp little pick friend. You kind of just get at it. It's like not, there's no great technique to this. You kind of just work your way down slicing it. I suppose that you could use a razor, but then you run the risk of cutting these little tiny wires and you don't want to do that. So I don't know. I find that like a little precision pick tool works really well. Then we get to this little part where you can see that there's rubber and this little cotton. I guess that the cotton, I don't really understand. I know that these cables were chosen and created because they're really good for this whole adventure. I can't lie to you and say that I understand all of these aspects, but I guess that this is anti-stretching. So we don't need it for here, but it's in the rest of the cable to help with stretching and whatnot and things I don't understand. And this little rubber is just little rubber shielding, probably has a really important reason that I don't quite understand, but you just snip that off too. Snip. So now, Moomin, take a little look. Take a little look at that. This is my dog, Moomin. She's a very important factor in this. She's a very important factor in Samufacturing. But we have these little wires. She is so done with me. And there's a few different standards that you can wire this with that I don't understand, but they're really important, and I'm sure. The primary thing that we want to make sure of is that whatever is done on this end is done on this end. And for this one, for what I use generally, is just like pinout A standard, which is going to consist of going broken green to solid green to broken orange to solid blue to broken blue to solid orange to broken brown and then solid brown. Very interesting stuff. So yeah, I just generally want to get this all in the right format. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use an actual connector. This connector that I was not an extremely prepared person and didn't pull out. So I'm going to pull it out now. And we have this fun little bag of a bunch of connectors. And hopefully finding a tray isn't going to be a total bummer, but I have a feeling it is going to be a slight bummer. Do we have one in here? At SoundTools, we use two types of connectors, these little white ones and a little orange one. Because we use both, I thought that I would just show you in two videos the two different types of connectors. So on the SuperCAT Sound, I'm using the little white connectors. On the SuperCAT, I'm using the white connectors. And on the SuperCAT Sound, I'll be using the yellow connectors. There is a difference. I know that the yellow ones are a little bit more expensive. I don't know the intricacies. I don't think I'm saying that word right, but I don't know the details as to why, what makes them different. But I do know that they're different, and that is all I'll say on that matter. But now that we have our little tray friend, we're basically just gonna line these guys up in the order that we want them to be. Whatever you're using, standard A, standard B, whatever. And I like to just grab four at a time. You slide them in. I love that you're gonna be able to hear Moomin snoring in this video. Honestly, I think it's gonna be a great addition. So now that I have these four in, we're gonna just do the other four. I find that with these little white trays, it's good to, just do four at a time. We'll have a little bit of a different method for the yellow trays, but you just kind of line them up and you slide them in and you make sure that they're all straight. After you do this, it's really important that you just kind of check to make sure that you have a broken solid, broken solid, broken solid, broken solid, because that's just a really good quick check to make sure that you have at least the base levels of rightness. If you have two brokens next to each other, you know you've done something wrong. So now you have this little shielding that you can just twist up. Twist, twist, twist. I like to do this part after. Some people do it before. I like to do it afterwards so I can kind of really put it in the back so that it works better with the connector, which I am looking at this guy, and it's not the right connector, unfortunately. Here we go. Here's the right connector. I am so sorry for being unprepared. So we have this little guy and it's going to end up sitting right here. So you kind of want this little tray to be at the top of it because the tops of the little tiny cables are going to sit right at the top. And this guy is going to sit at the back. So I like to twist him at the end so I can know where he's laying. Once you do this, you're going to kind of give yourself a tiny bit of space, line it up here, make it a little bit taller. So you just push it up a little bit and you're going to take some scissors. I like these scissors because they really are good at grabbing the little cables. You can also use wire cutters. These are really nice when you're having kind of like wily wires because it does a good job at pressing them down before you cut them. But you just kind of cut right across and you push those into a little trash pile. Take this, bend this little tab. We'll be dealing with that in a minute. And you kind of just line it up and hope that things go well. Which it looks like things actually went very easy. Sometimes it's not that easy and you kind of have to get in there with like a tool kind of like this to push things in there to like line them up properly and make sure that they're all laying flat. But this one actually went really well.
And sometimes you just get those and they feel so good. So what we're going to do is hope that my face doesn't get too far into this. Yeah. What you really are looking for here is seeing copper at the top here. You can also come around to the back, and if you can see cables all up, pushed up against there, you're really happy. So it looks like we're doing pretty good, and you really just gotta love when it fits in properly. So I complained a lot in this first shoot that we were doing when I forgot the boot about my tools that weren't great, and they were nice and provided me with a bunch of tools that I'm proceeding not to use because I didn't like them as much as my tools that do the job that I'm used to. And they do a great job. So sorry for complaining and then just dismissing all of your suggestions. But that's what I did. But so now you just crimp it down and use this little crimper guy who's, you just have to crimp it a few more times than some of the other crimpers out there. But that's okay. You just want to make sure that the copper's all connecting. And now you can see that it's not going to fall off because those little copper bits have actually like kind of bitten into those little tiny cables, and now it's really sturdy. However, it's not the sturdiest, and this is where this last part comes in. I like to wrap this guy around here twice. SoundTools does it twice, generally. And just for a better connection for the ground, you bend this little piece back into place. And now this is like, I guess, a support mechanism. This is one of the tools I complained about and they gave me more, but I like this tool even if I complained about it. It would only be better if it had more grippiness right here. It's a little bit smooth, but kind of this like L-shaped thing is rad, and you kind of take it around the back and bend it around, and it creates this really nice little support here so that you can see it's not gonna bend around, or if it does bend around, you know, it's supported. So now we have these little bits here that we just snip off. We take our little wire cutters here and go, bye-bye. We listen to a lovely little dog that's scratching at the door because they're little angels. And you see here, this is our completed one that I had already done earlier, and here's our one that we just did. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna take off this to show you guys. Usually we won't put the this connector on until we're absolutely finished because this is just a special connector type that we do. But here we are with the two RJ45s. Here's our little Klein tools. I'm not selling you the Klein tools, but it is what I use, and I use it because it was given to me. We plug these little friends in and we go, these be all good. And look at that, we have a pass. I really was just so dreading the moment on this video where I show you guys something and it turns out I'm a fool and don't know how to do this at all. So now that we know that this is all passed, it also shows that these RJ45 connections are totally good, which is obviously another type of connection that you can do. For these though, for the SuperCAT cables, a lot of them we end up doing is has these little neutrik connectors, which neutrik's a really fun word. I don't really know much about anything other than that. To get these on, I kind of just push these together, line it up, and we say, hello, please go on there. You wiggle it around until it listens to you. You make sure that everything is good. Watch me make this whole thing and then just mess around with getting one of the easiest parts on here. But I gotta say, sometimes it's a little bit annoying. Once it's on there though, it's really sturdy. Okay, so what I generally do is I tighten it a little bit of the way and then I'll put the other one on as well. Because how you wanna make sure that they're set super properly is by actually plugging him into the little connection box, which I'll show you in a second. So we have our little testers here. You just plug it in, tighten it up. You don't want to make it too tight. You want to make sure it's sitting properly. It's all sturdy. Click, click. We'll do the same thing over here. And click. Click, and now we can actually test our friend that we just made. And look at that, look at that. We are all happy. I know you can't see these lights too well, but if we didn't have such brightness, these would all be green. And as you can see, these are all green, which means that all of our connections are happy. And we're using the rat sniffer and the cat box to test these cables, and we're all good. And that is how you terminate a SuperCAT cable. I hope that that wasn't the most confusing video, because I don't know how to make videos, but I hope it was illuminating for some and also just kind of cool to see one of our processes. We're going to be doing another video also for the SuperCAT sound cable, which just has a little bit of a different termination process. So go check that out when we release that. All right, Samufacturing out.